my way was to make it as authentic as I could. I mean, there's great fight sequences in a lot of boxing movies, but when I go to a fight and I'm sitting there and I'm watching a fight, I'm going, how do you make it feel like this, where there's no cuts, where you're watching it happen in front of you, mm-hmm. and you feel the crowd swelling and dropping, and oh, and you see that happen. So I went to all the fights with. I took Jake to all the fights, the Mayweather fights and Pacquiao, and Cotto fights, and I sat down with the HBO guys, all the HBO people, and my goal was, and my DP, I said, let's light it so that you don't have to stop to light it, and we did all the rounds, like you would do rounds, so that's why Jake was in such good condition. I said, you got to fight, and we're going to do the rounds, 3-minute rounds, and we're going to do it just like a real fight. And if you get tired, you wrap up, you grab each other, and, you know, the referee, we had Tony Weeks, the real referee, you know, he break them up. And, you know, if you could break them up and sneak a punch in, you know, without hurting the other guy, you should do what you would really do. And so I shot it as authentic as I could, thinking that I'm not going to do many cuts. But I was only going to do the cuts in the final fight during the last sequences where I put the audience in the ring, mm-hmm. where it gets more violent, and you got the POVs, and you're the fighter now. Because, you know, when you sit with a bunch of people at home watching pay-per-view and you're all getting excited and screaming and your guy's winning, I said, that's the feeling I want. It wasn't necessarily trying to outdo any other boxing movie. It was just, I just wanted it to feel like you're at a real fight. And when you watch the great fights, you watch Gotti and Ward, or you watch, you know, Ali fight, you know, Ali and Frazier and those fights, or Sugar Ray and Duran. And I remember being a kid screaming and being excited about those fights. So I wanted it to feel that way.
So did it make it hard to cut or easy to cut? I mean, you have a lot of footage.
It made it hard, really hard, because you're looking at everything, you know, as a fighter, you're watching his footwork, and he might have thrown a good punch, but his feet are all over the mat. So you cut it first for technique, to make sure that the boxing, and he's turning his punches over, and he's turning when he's punching. He's doing all the basic things of boxing. And then you want to make it exciting for an audience. So I cut it together first with the least amount of cuts. And I had them throw punches as close as possible and touch each other's face so you see the glove hit the face without cuts. And I did that first. And then I went in and I said, okay, I need to spice it up here because the energy's going up. So I would then use other angles, mm-hmm. like the photographer's point of view is where you see those angles that are more vicious because you're closer. And you see them hit the ring, and you see the blood fly and the sweat fly. And a few times you saw real blood and sweat fly because Jake got punched. And the other guy, he punched the other guy too. So a couple times you caught the sweat and the blood come off their face. That was real. Mm. You know.
How many cameras were you rolling?
About 12. Mm. Yeah, I had about 12 cameras. I had about two in the corners. I had a crane. I had some 5Ds. Then I had a steady cam at times, you know, capturing certain things. Then I had the audience cameras, you know, so I could catch it in the moments, mm-hmm. when it was really happening. And the audience didn't know what to expect, so we had the crowd. As opposed to like, okay, cut, reset, mm-hmm. I did that as little as possible. So round by round, they didn't know what was going to happen. So there were scenes that we choreographed where they would punch each other at the same time. Mm-hmm. So the crowd was reacting in real time to these things.
Well, one of the beats in the movie is that he knocks a guy down, and then there's a punch that he doesn't connect on. Mm-hmm. And it's a moment where you're thinking, you're in a movie, you're watching, you know that people don't really hit each other in a movie, but is he doing it intentionally? Was that meant to look real? I mean, it's a kind of a fascinating moment. It made it feel more real by the fact that it was it seemed like a mistake almost.
Well, yeah, a lot of punches don't connect. You watch a fight, a lot of punches don't connect. A lot of times, guys are just measuring each other and jabbing, and nothing really happens until like a couple flurries. Mm-hmm. Then he's up against the ropes, and they reset, and everybody gets their rhythm again. It was the miss that really makes it work. It's the times where a guy does slip a punch, or a guy does punch, and then he misses the other punch. Because a knockout, it's like that. Mm-hmm. It's so fast, you go like, oh, what happened? And then you see slow-mo, but he hit him, and then he threw another punch, mm-hmm. thinking, well, I'll stick him with this one, and this will be the power punch. But this punch caught him, right on the chin. And then by the time this one came around, he was already going down. So you see those in fights all the time. Because even fighters, you know, like one's a setup and one's the actual punch. The setup actually takes them out.